In last lecture, we had started with alternating current. So we will just do a quick revision of last lecture and then we will move further. So we saw what is the definition of alternating current. So alternating, the name only says alternating. That means it changes. So the alternating quantity or alternating current is that quantity which changes its magnitude and direction periodically. That means at particular for that period only it will be positive, then it will go to the negative. For the same period it will change its magnitude and direction. So it is the definition of alternating current. Now after that we saw the generation, right? We saw generation. So in generation what we saw, how does the AC current is generated. So there was nothing hard to remember, it was very easy. So how we can generate AC? So here this is the north pole, this is the south pole, right? We have created here magnetic field. So this is the magnetic field created, right? So here we have to place one conductor. So this is the conductor, right? This is the conductor. So whenever this conductor is moving, in this magnetic field, or what else we can do? We can move this magnetic field and keep our conductor constant, right? So what is the important thing? We have to just move, there must be motion of one particular thing, magnet or this conductor. So in this case what we are doing, whenever this conductor is rotating, it cuts this magnetic flux, and due to that EMF is induced in this conductor. So whenever we have to apply a resistance, or you can apply a bulb. So what is the main concept here? Whenever the conductor, moving conductor is placed, in magnetic field, EMF is induced. So this what we have seen in our last lecture. Now after that we saw the magnitude of EMF at different instants. That means this coil, the motion of this coil will determine the induced EMF, right? So at 0 degree, that means at whenever this is at zero, that angle is zero, then there is no induced EMF, right? At 90 degree, EMF induced is maximum. So we will see it once again. So this is the north pole, this is the south pole. So our conductor, so this is our magnetic field, okay? These are the flux. Now this is our conductor. So this conductor, it is A, and this end is B, okay? So what is happening in this position? Conductor is vertical, right? A and B, these are the verticals. That means it is parallel to the flux. So no flux is cut by this, in this position no flux is cut by the conductor. So no flux cut, there will be no induced EMF. So at angle theta is equal to 0, we know the formula BLV sin theta. EMF is equal to BLV sin theta. So here theta is 0, so EMF induced is 0. There is no induced EMF. Now this is about first position. So I will just draw here graph so you can understand. So this is how our AC waveform is. Right, this is our AC waveform. So I'll just write here the angles at 0. Okay, at 0, this is 45, this is 90, this will be 180, this will be 360. Okay, so at 0, angle, EMF induced is 0. So here at 0, induced EMF is 0. Now we'll move to the second. Now this is north pole, this is south pole. In second, we have to rotate this at certain angle, right? So these are our magnetic or the flux. So now what we have to do, we have to rotate this conductor. So I'll rotate it by 45 degrees. Okay, this conductor, we have rotated it by 45 degrees. Okay, so what will happen now? This is A and this is B. Okay, this is A and this is B. Now what will happen? There are some flux cut by this conductor. Some flux are cutting by this conductor. So this cutting flux, due to this, what happens here? Theta is equal to 45. And after substituting the value in this formula, EMF is equal to BLV sin theta, we get some amount of EMF. So here in graph, there is some amount of EMF produced in this second part, right? Now we will go to the third. So this is North Pole, this is South Pole. So these are the magnetic flux. Now our conductor will be in this position, right? We have placed the theta is equal to 90 degrees. So this was 0, after that we tilted it to, this is 0, this is 45, and this is 90 degrees. So this is at 90 degrees. This is A and this is B. Okay, are you getting this? This is A and this is B. We are moving it anti-clockwise. Okay, so this is A and this is B. So what's happening here? Maximum amount of EMF is induced. Why? Because maximum number of flux are cut in this position, that is at 90 degrees. In this position, conductor cuts maximum flux. So at theta is equal to 90, whenever we put it, sine 90 is equal to 1, right? So here BLV sine 90, after substituting this value, we get the induced EMF. So here you can see this is at angle 90 and this is the EMF induced, okay? So here at 90 degrees, we are getting the maximum value of induced EMF, okay? We are getting here maximum value. Now what will happen at the fourth? This is north, this is south. These are the flux. Now we have to rotate it at anti-clockwise. So what we'll do? We will rotate it like this. Okay, now this is A and this is B. B is going above. Okay, so in this position, angle again is less than 90 degrees. So here angle is less than 90. So we know at 90 degree, at the angle 90 degree, maximum flux are induced. So whenever the angle goes below the 90, then what will happen? EMF will be also reduced, right? At 90 degree, maximum EMF is induced, and below 90 degree, EMF induced is low. So here you can see after 90, again the induced EMF is decreasing, right? Magnitude is decreasing. Okay. So now here in fifth, what will happen? It will again go to this position, right? So now here, this will go to this position. That means this is A. So this is A and this is B. Now here you can see A has gone down. A has went down and B has come above. So here in this vertical position, it is parallel to flux. So theta is equal to 0. So no EMF is induced, right? So here no EMF is induced. So here you can see at 180. Zero EMF is induced, right? No EMF is induced. Now again at sixth position, what will happen? So compare it with this. I'll just draw here. Sixth position, what will happen? This is our North Pole, this is our South Pole, and these are our flux. Okay. Now this will tilt again like this. Okay. But here, what is the position of this? This is A, this is B, and this is A, right? Now what will happen? EMF will be induced, but in opposite direction, right? It will go in negative. Negative EMF is induced. Are you getting this? So this is the negative EMF, because the B and A, the conductor, this is the half cycle, right? This is half cycle. And from here, another half cycle is going to begin, right? So this is that cycle. So here same, everything will be same, similar this way. But what will happen? It will happen, EMF will be induced, but in opposite direction, right? Direction changes. Now here you can see here B has come above, here A is above. Here B is down, here A is down. Okay, so what happens? EMF will be induced same, but it will change the direction. So same thing will happen. What will happen in seventh? It will be same. This conductor will come in this position, but here this will be B and this will be A. And here at 90 degree, maximum amount of EMF will be induced. So here you can see, here is the maximum point, but it is in opposite direction, right? Now similarly in 8th, what will happen? This is north, this is south. Now in this, this will go like this, below 90 degree. This conductor will move like this. So here this angle is less than 90 degrees, so EMF induced will be less, but in opposite direction. So here you can see induced EMF is less than 90 degrees. Okay, so this is how the waveform is drawn by calculating this with the formula EMF is equal to BLV sine theta. Now we will see further AC waveform. We will see the calculation So we know this is our graph. This is our graph of AC waveform. So what happens? Here what happens? As the angle changes, the magnitude and direction changes periodically. So this is the period, right? This is the period. So for this period, it is positive. And again, after completing this period, it will go in this period and it is negative, right? So the variation of EMF with the time can be represented on the graph. So this is our graphical representation. So now, our coil. So this was the coil was rotating in between the magnetic field. Magnetic field, in this between magnetic field, north and south, our coil was moving, right? This is our coil and which was rotating with this speed, that is N. So let N is equal to coil or conductor rotate at N RPM. So this is the coil or conductor that rotates at N RPM, and angular velocity omega. Omega is nothing but angular speed. This is the angular speed. So you have learned this in physics, angular speed and all. So omega is nothing but the angular speed or velocity. Angular speed or velocity in radian per second. So omega is nothing but angular speed or velocity. N is coil or conductor rotates. The rotation is given in N and angular speed is given in omega. So this is omega. Now here we know the formula BLV sin theta. EMF we were giving it by BLV sin theta. So what was B? B was flux density. B was flux density. That means here magnetic field was created. So the strength of this magnetic field is called as flux density. Okay. Now V is linear velocity. V is linear velocity. This was angular velocity. This is linear velocity. And B. And what was B? B is breadth. Okay. B is breadth of this conductor. Okay. Now coil rotates at angle theta. So this is our angle theta, right? So theta is nothing but angle of rotation. Angle of rotation. Now L is length of conductor. Length of conductor. So these are the terms that we require. B is equal to flux density, that is the strength of this magnetic field. V is linear velocity. B is breadth of this conductor. Theta is angular rotation. We were rotating it by 0, 45, 90. So we saw in last. So this is nothing but the angular rotation. L is for length of this conductor. This is our conductor which is rotating. This is length of conductor. So we know as omega, that is angular speed, is nothing but 2 pi n upon 60. Why n upon 60? Because as in 1 second, revolution in 1 second is n by 60. Okay. So in 1 second, how many times this coil or conductor rotates is nothing but the 1 second revolution. Revolutions in 1 second. So what we did here, omega is equal to 2 pi, and what we want here in radian per second, we want it in per second. So we divided this n by 60. Okay, so this was 2 pi n, but we want it in second, so we divided it by 60. So omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. Just remember this, omega, I'll write here, omega is equal to 2 pi into n divided by 60 radian per second. So as we know, linear velocity, how it is given? Linear velocity is equal to angular velocity. Linear velocity is given as angular velocity into radius. So our radius is B by 2. Why? Because breadth is here diameter. So breadth is considered as diameter. So diameter, how we convert it? Divided it by 2. So it will give us radius, right? So our B is nothing but our diameter. So whenever we divide B by 2, then it means it is radius, right? So instead of radius, we can substitute B by 2, and angular velocity, omega, that is omega, angular velocity means omega, right? And radius is B by 2. So we can write here omega into B by 2. So now here, linear velocity we can give it by V is equal to W into B by 2. So this is our linear velocity. Now, induced EMF. EMF induced at any instant is given as, so this is the formula, we have learnt it earlier. EMF is equal to BLV sine theta. So we can write EMF is equal to BLV sine theta. So this EMF is induced, BLV sine theta is for one conductor. So this is our coil, right? So this is our coil. So this is the one conductor. So this part is one conductor. So in our coil, how many conductors are there? There are two conductors. So this is one and this is one. So what, how we can write the EMF for two conductors? This is EMF for one conductor. So we can write 2BLV sine theta for both the conductors. Both conductors. Are you getting the point? This is our coil which is rotating. So this is the coil which is rotating in the magnetic field. So this is the one conductor and this is the another. So we have two conductors. So here we just multiplied it by 2. So what we can write here? 2BLV sine theta. 2BLV sine theta. So here induced EMF. EMF induced at any instant is E is equal to BLV sine theta in one conductor. So it is in one conductor. So in two conductors, we have to just multiply it by 2. Right? So why we have saying here BLV EMF induced at any instant? Because we have to calculate, if you want to calculate at any instant, then what we require? We require this 90. That means we require angle. And we have to know this. All the values, what is the flux density, what is length, what is velocity, right? So here, at any instant, this will remain same for everything. But the angle theta will change. At every time, theta will change. Conductor, everything, length, breadth of conductor will remain same. But theta will change. So if you want to calculate EMF, induced EMF at any instant means what? At that particular point. So at that particular point, we just need to calculate the angle. If we must know only the angle, so substituting the angle, we will get the induced EMF. So for two conductors, E is equal to 2BLV sine theta. Now here, E is equal to 2BLV sine theta. So in last, what we calculated? We calculated the linear velocity. So what is linear velocity? V is equal to omega into B by 2. So we'll substitute the value here. So E is equal to 2BL, instead of V, what we have to substitute here? Omega B by 2 sine theta. What we did? V is equal to, we substituted omega into B by 2. Okay. Now here, as you can see here, length into breadth. So here you can see, we will just take these terms together. And here one thing, this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled, right? So now here what we can do? BLB. So this B I took inside and this omega sine theta will remain outside. So what I did here, I just cancelled this 2 and this 2. And this B, L and this small b, I just took them together. So now we know here, length into breadth, this small L and this small b. So these are nothing but length and breadth. So what will they do together after multiplication? This is area of loop, right? So what we can substitute here instead of this L and b? What we can substitute? L and b, that is area, that means this is area of loop. So we'll substitute L into b is equal to a. So here B will remain same and L into B it is A into omega sine theta. What we substituted instead of L into B we substituted here A. Now here B into A means what? B into A that is flux density multiplied by area. This is flux density multiplied by area. That means maximum flux when coil is horizontal. Okay, so that means from the whole conductor, maximum number of flux will be cut. So here, what we'll write instead of this B into A? That is maximum flux. And how is the maximum flux given? Phi max. So what we can write instead of B into A? That is flux density into area. That is phi max. So B into A we can write here. Phi max, that is maximum flux. So what we can write? B into A, that is phi max omega sine theta. Okay, clear up to this? We have just substituted the values. Okay. So now what we are going to do is we will calculate it for number of turns. That means this is our coil, right? So this is our single coil. But whenever there are number of turns to this coil, then what the another formula will be? So number of turns that we will denote or we will give it by T. So T is for number of turns of coil. Okay, this was for single turn. But when there are number of turns, okay, then what will be the formula? So we will substitute here T is equal to number of coils. So what we have to do, we have to just substitute the T here, that is phi max T omega sine theta. Why we substituted here? For single coil we will just substitute T is equal to 1 and the formula will be same like this. But whenever there are more number of turns, if there are number of turns of coil, then we have to substitute value of T here. Okay, so phi max is equal to T omega sine theta. So now what we will do? We will calculate it for maximum flux or maximum induced EMF for maximum induced EMF. So we know when this maximum EMF will be induced at theta is equal to 90 degree maximum EMF will be induced. So we have to substitute here theta 90 degree. So sine theta, that is sine 90, is equal to 1. So what we can write? E is equal to, so here we are calculating for maximum value. So we know here it will be maximum. EMF induced will be maximum. So here what we'll write? E max. Okay. Why? Because we have substituted here the maximum value, that is maximum EMF will be induced, so we have calculated it for the 90 degree. So we substituted here theta is equal to 90, that is 1. So E max is equal to phi max TW. Where this sine theta went? We substituted here sine 90. So it is 1. So at the angle 90 degree, maximum EMF is induced. So I have just written here E max. So here E max is equal to phi max TW. Now what we have to do is we have to substitute this phi max TW. E max is equal to phi max TW. We have to substitute this in this equation. So here E is equal to E max sine theta. So this is the equation of alternating EMF. What is equation? E is equal to E max sine theta. So what we did here, we first calculated from this equation, we calculated for the maximum amount of induced EMF. So for the maximum amount of induced EMF, angle is 90 degrees. So we substituted here theta is equal to 90. So here E is equal to phi max TW. We will get just phi max TW. What is it? E max is equal to phi max TW. Then what we did? We just substituted this value, that is phi max into TW, it is equal to E max. So we substituted this value in this equation. Okay. So E is equal to E max sine theta. So this is our equation of alternating EMF. So from this, what we can understand, as the angle theta changes, EMF is varying, right? Induced EMF varies as the sine of angle theta changes. So this is the about the equation. Now we will see what does it mean by different terms that are used in this sinusoidal waveform. So this is our waveform, that is AC waveform. So now, what is waveform? So the definition of waveform is the shape of curve obtained by plotting the instantaneous values of voltage and current on theta on x-axis. Okay, so what we are doing here, the theta means angle. So here we are plotting the theta. That means this is 0 at theta angle 0. This is at 45. This is at 90, this is at 180, and this is at 360, right? So what we are doing here, to calculate this, so we must know the formula BLV sine theta, right? So substituting the values of theta in different angles, we will get some value, right? We will get some value of induced EMF. So what we have to do, we have to just substitute that values here. And we will get certain points, right? We will get at 0, it is 0. At 90, there is some maximum value. At 180, it is again 0. So we will get at 45, it has some again value which is less than 90, right? So here again, we will get some value. So after joining this, we get certain graph, right? So the shape of curve obtained by plotting the instantaneous values of voltage or current on coordinate and time on x-axis. What is on x-axis? That is angle. So on x-axis it is theta on x-axis is known as waveform. So we know the formula E is equal to E max sine theta, or it is omega t. So we calculated here E is equal to E max sine theta. So waveform is nothing but it is shape of curve. So here we are getting the shape of curve obtained by plotting the instantaneous values of voltage or current on the coordinates, that is x and y. On x-axis we are plotting the angles, right? That is theta. So EMF varies. How does this EMF varies? EMF varies according to this angle. So angle changes, EMF also changes. At 90 degree, EMF induced is maximum. So such curves of varying EMF is sine curve, and EMF is known as sinusoidal EMF. So this EMF is called as sinusoidal EMF. So this is about the waveform. This is the definition of waveform. Now second one is cycle. Okay, what we will see now? Cycle. So one complete set of positive and negative values of an alternating quantity is known as cycle. So here, one complete set of positive, so this is in positive and this is negative EMF, right? So set of one positive and one negative is one cycle. So this is one cycle. Up to here, this is one cycle. This will start from here, this is another cycle. So this is set of one cycle. Okay, so one complete set of positive and negative is one cycle, right? So this is called a cycle. This is cycle, and this is another cycle. So combining these two are two cycles. So single cycle is one positive and one negative. So this is the called cycle. So one complete set of positive and negative values of an alternating quantity is called as cycle. Now we will see time period. Time taken by AC quantity to complete one cycle. So how much time it takes to complete this whole cycle is called as time period. Time taken by the AC quantity to complete one cycle. Is called as time period. Now fourth one is frequency. So what is frequency? It is given as F and time period is given as T. So what is frequency? Okay, so we'll see what is frequency. So frequency is number of cycles per second. So what you have to remember? Number of cycles per second. In 1 second, how much cycle it completes? Okay, so in 1 second, how much cycle it completes? So now consider if f is equal to 50, that means in 1 second it completes this 50 cycles. So these are 2 cycles, right? So in 1 second it completes 50 cycles. So this is called frequency. If they give frequency is equal to 50, that means in 1 second it completes 50 cycles. So how a time period is given? So this, what does it mean by time period? Time period is nothing but the time required to complete 1 cycle. Time period required to complete 1 cycle. So for 50, how we can give the time period for this 50 frequency for 50? How we can give the time period? So time period is equal to t is equal to 1 upon f. So here 1 upon 50. So the time period is 1 upon 50. So what is frequency? The number of cycles per second. In 1 second, how many cycles it can complete is called as frequency. Now we will see the amplitude. So what is amplitude? The maximum value. So this is the amplitude. So here this curve has the maximum value, right? There is certain maximum value. So this is your maximum value. So this is nothing but the amplitude. Okay, amplitude. So here in negative also, this is amplitude, the highest point. So this is the highest point. So this is called as amplitude. So the maximum value, positive or negative, of the alternating quantity attains during the 1 cycle. Okay, so this is the 1 cycle. So in 1 cycle there are, so this is the maximum value. So this is called as amplitude. So in graph, just remember, this part is amplitude. That means the bigger portion of cycle is the amplitude. So this is about the amplitude. Now we have another quantity, that is speed. Frequency has relation with speed. Frequency has relation with speed and number of poles. So here, what does it mean by poles? So here we saw, these are the 2 magnets, right? So this is the 2 pole. This is 2 pole. And 4 pole means what? So this is north and this is north and this is south. So this is 2 pole. And 4 pole means it will be like this. So like this. So the conductor is placed here. Here the conductor will be placed here. Okay, so this is 2 pole, this is 4 pole. So they have got some relation between them. So whenever we place conductor in 2 pole, then we get 1 cycle. Okay, we get 1 cycle. And whenever the conductor is placed between 2 poles, we get 2 cycles. Okay, we get 2 cycles. So from this we can write number of cycles. How we can calculate number of cycles? So in 2 poles, when there are 2 poles, we get 1 complete cycle, and when there are 4 poles, we get 2 cycles. So how we can write the relation? P by 2. Okay, P by 2. So here, now here number of poles are 2. So I'll substitute here value of P, 2. 2 by 2, that is 1. So we get here 1 cycle, right? Now here there are 4 poles. So number of poles, 4. 4 divided by 2, this is 2. So when there are 4 poles, we get 2 cycles, right? So this is about the number of cycles. And now here, N is equal to speed of conductor in RPM. That means at how much speed it rotates, right? So we have seen in last also, it is given as N divided by 60, that is per second. Okay, so speed per second, it is N divided by 60. So we can write here, frequency of EMF in cycles per second. That is number of cycles per second means frequency. So we can write here frequency is equal to number of cycles per revolution into revolution in 1 second. Okay, so here number of cycles per second, how we will get the number of cycles per second? So here we have written the formula, number of cycles. we get the number of cycles by the formula P divided by 2. So we will substitute your number of cycles. How we will get it? P divided by 2. And revolution in 1 second. So here revolution in 1 second, that is speed. How we give, write the speed? N divided by 60. So we will substitute here N divided by 60. So P into N divided by 120. So frequency is equal to P into N divided by 120. So this is the formula. So what we did here, we just wrote here this frequency is equal to number of cycles per revolution into revolution in 1 second. So how we give it? So here number of cycles we calculated, we made here formula, that is P divided by 2, that is number of poles. So here there are 2 number of poles, so we'll substitute here 2, 2 by 2, we get here 1 cycle. So this is the formula to calculate the number of cycles. So we substituted here P by 2 and revolution in 1 second. So how we get? That is speed, that is N divided by 60. So here N divided by 60, and then we get this formula. So if you have any doubts, then you can ask.